much. We now invite Dr. Subhash Sippy to deliver his acceptance speech.
The dignitaries on the dais, Dr. Ganeshan, Chief Guest Mr. Patil, Dr. Rao, Dr. Sardeshmog, Mr. Lakshmi Narayan, Mr. Munawar Peer Boy, Dr. Roshan Kazi, Professor Javed Khan, and the organizers behind this checkmate, and the aspiring students of Alan Institute of Management Science. And you are the Make India forces of the country. And now, after JNU, you are the political forces of the country. So, listening to the soothing and self-inspiring words by Dr. Ganeshan, so I'm little, you know, in doubt whether the credit goes to me or to his unrivaled vocabulary. So, it's a great honor for me to receive this award from the organizers of Alana Institute of Management. That's also in the 40th year of my industrial as an industrialist. See, my career is, if you say, it's a trilogy. An engineer, a scientist, and an industrialist. Like you, I came to Pune in 1975 with just an engineering degree and with lot of dreams. So I came from an alien state and came to Pune for a job. I came, I saw, but no conquering. But I got myself surrendered to this beautiful city and the people. So I started when my all doors are shut, I couldn't get a job. And without any one day's professional experience, I started this company in 1976. And from 1976 to 83, the whole 7 years, it was an industrial hibernation for me. You know, you might have heard of political hibernation, like N.D. Tiwari had 2 to 3 years, A.R. Andule had 3-4 years, but industrial hibernation may be little unheard. So, during the hibernation, I went to NCL library, got immersed in the books, scientific books, and my metaphor is towards scientist. So I became a scientist, I started developing products. Then in 83, I developed the first floor coating of the country, and others followed us. Now today it's a 800 crores segment, market segment. I'm proud to say that, I started this trend. To the checkmating question of Dr. Ganeshan, that making India industrial manufacturing hub is a myth or reality. My answer is, it's a reality. See, if you see that India, see, we have to see that reality also. India is people having secondary intelligence. Means that we are not inventors, we are reinventors, inventors. Even me, I also did my reinvention. What Professor Otto Beer in 1937, he invented the polyurethanes. After 40 years, I reinvented. But at that time, there was a big gap of 40 years, 3 or 4 decades between developed nations' technology and Indian's technology. Today, not that. Last year, I developed a new product called polyaspartics. And just a matter of 3 years, the gap, the technology gap. So the question is that, we are not inventors. If you see the Nobel laureates, we have produced almost 4 or 5, whereas UK produced 88 Nobel laureates. So one product, you have two sides. One, how you conceive the idea, then develop that product, and that is part of the research. And then when you make a product, then they find for how to manufacture at the lowest cost with the trained people. So that's the manufacturing hub going to be India, because we have the largest pool of engineers. So it's going to be a reality if we allow this present government to function. So lastly, about this lifetime achievement, he explained to me, but you know, I don't know where this award originated, but as far as I know, I heard the first lifetime achievement in the Filmfare Awards, and they gave to the actor Dharmendra. That was the time, you know, we are fed up with his acting. And the Filmfare thought, you know, this is the only way to make him stop acting. And he never acted afterwards. Similarly, please don't give me a hint, Dr. Ganeshan. I'm not kidding. I'm going to leapfrog to new heights. Thank you very much. Thank you for all.